What's up, y'all?
What's up? How y'all doing?
Down. We over here breathing out, breathing in.
It's American oxygen, baby.
All day. You already know.
Coming at you live from the kitchen, baby.
Live from the kitchen, yeah.
You know, once again.
I am yours truly, Big City, International Hood Boy, Ambassador of New York, Prince of the Ghetto, Brooklyn's firstborn son. And this is my man.
Swami O, Will Robeson, Pretty Will.
Is what they call him.
Man, you know, how y'all doing? You know, today's topic is a serious topic, and we're talking about what does it mean to be a proud American?
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
And what does that look like for black people, and what does that look like for white people? What's the difference?
Is there a difference?
Is there a difference? Does that difference matter? And if it does matter, what can we do to be on the same page about it? Because we all want the same things as human beings.
Absolutely.
You know, so how can we be proud Americans and talk about important things, you know, and try to move everything forward?
Well, I want to say this. I think I'm going to take it from the other angle, maybe backwards a little bit. I don't think it should be considered not being a proud American or to be un-American to say things about our own country that we think should be better. Mm-hmm. I think sometimes this subject is rooted in that. It's rooted in one side of the table, looking at the other side of the table and saying, that's un-American, you're not a proud American because you spoke about something that was broke and needed to be fixed, and maybe nobody was saying anything about it. So I don't think that's un-American to, you know, some people call it raging against the machine, but I'm just saying, I just think if I see something that is wrong with our country, something that is against the principles that, you know, those who run the country say this country is based on, I don't think I should be castigated or attacked for pointing that out and saying that's broke, that needs to be fixed. That doesn't make me a communist, a socialist, or whatever. It just makes me observant. And I think it makes me a proud American to stand up and say that, knowing I might get, I might be thrown into the fire, in the storm, because I brought it up in the first place. So I'm going to start a conversation off like that.
Mm-hmm. Well, you know, it's like, well, what does America really, like, what do we stand for? You know, but that's what it boils down to. I mean, do we stand for things that are wrong, were we ever right? Like, was everything all good to begin with?
No, it started on a bad foot. We're trying to get it right now, yeah. But I think those who benefit and have benefited historically from those wrongs, pretty words were written, but the principles and the credo was not lived up to. Right. So I think those who benefit and have benefited from the way the wrongs, call people who say, hey, that's wrong, they call them un-American.
Right.
You know, Tea Party, you know, some right-wing cats, you know, they look at, look at simple things like women should get equal pay, you know, why can't we have universal health care for everybody.
Right.
Why can't college, at least city college, be paid for the American citizens?
Why don't we get a fair shake?
You know, why
the justice system?
Why don't black people get black and brown people get a fair shake in the justice system? Those who historically benefited from the unfairness look at people who are saying what we're saying and say, he's a radical, he's a this, he's a that, he's an American. When in reality, it's like a magic game. It's like three card Molly. The person pointing his finger is really the one that's being un-American, in my opinion.
What y'all think, though? You know, serious topic. You know, why don't y'all chime in and let us know how y'all feel about it?
Yeah. And by the way, you can hit me personally on Big City IHB on Facebook. If you don't hit Will, you can hit myself. Let us both know what you think.
Word up. Peace. Live from the